Greetings and welcome to another thrilling episode of Veronica Explains. I'm Veronica, and today I'm going to talk about Shortwave, my favorite Linux application to listen to and manage internet radio stations. Now, I can already hear the comments, but Veronica, can't you just listen to Spotify? Well, basically, I don't like algorithm-driven music recommendations all that much. That's something I mentioned in my iPod video a few months back, but I enjoy a more human-centered approach to music discovery, and radio has always been a part of that for me. You're free to have your own opinion about it, and that's okay. Anyway, while I'm a big fan of traditional over-the-air radio broadcasting, streaming radio, also known as internet radio or IP radio, is a great way of discovering new music to enjoy, particularly when it comes to genres that just aren't going to be available over the air. And on the Linux desktop, my favorite program for internet radio is Shortwave, maintained by Felix Häcker and readily available via FlatHub. There's also a community-driven version available in the Snap Store, but it looks like the Snappy Shortwave is at least a version behind the FlatHub version as of the time I'm recording this video. I can also see a community-supported version available in the Arch repos, which is awesome. Now, I know a few of you are going to have a hitch session in the comments because it's only officially supported via FlatHub. And as a fan of native packaging, I do get it. But if tools like FlatHub help developers more easily build and release software for the Linux desktop, I'm certainly not going to gripe about it. The app is written in Rust, and like Fragments, the BitTorrent application maintained by the same developer, it's a very straightforward, almost minimalist piece of software, which seeks to do one thing very well. It's part of the GNOME Circle family of applications, which means that while it's not a GNOME core application, it does follow the GNOME human interface guidelines and gets hosting resources from the GNOME project. Now, I routinely use Shortwave on my KDE Plasma desktop, and to me it looks just fine over there. But if you're the kind of person who can't stand the look and feel of GNOME applications, well, thanks for watching. I personally think the GNOME applications look great together, although I do wish it was easier to adopt skeuomorphic icons for applications. But that's really just a stylistic preference on my end, and I'm certainly not going to be raising any torches or pitchforks about it. Now, I barely have to explain how to use this application, but we're going to go through it anyway. Otherwise, it wouldn't be edutainment. To start with, your Linux desktop or laptop is going to need FlatHub enabled. Here in the roaring 2K20s, a few distros ship FlatHub support by default, such as Linux Mint. Other distros, like Fedora, might require you to approve third-party repositories. Most popular distros can pretty easily enable FlatHub support, and you can learn more about your distro's process over at flathub.org. Then, after completing that process, you can basically install it like any other Linux application. Or, if you're a terminal nerd like I am, once you have FlatHub support on your machine, you can install it with flatpak install de.hackerfelix.shortwave with the capital S on shortwave. However you end up installing the program, using it is probably the most straightforward thing I've ever shown on this channel. On opening, the application will show a cute little Welcome to Shortwave screen, and you can hit the big button to add new stations, or press the plus icon in the top left corner of the screen. A list of popular stations appears, which you can browse at your leisure, but I typically search for the stations I'm already listening to, such as Soma FM's Groove Salad. Side note, if you regularly listen to Soma FM as I do, make sure you donate financially to them if you can. Running IP radio is pricey, and great services like Soma FM deserve our support. Anyway, in the case of Groove Salad, I can see that a lot of different options pop up. Lossless, AAC, HLS, that sort of thing. That's because it's pulling the list of services from radio-browser.info, and regular folks like you and me have added a variety of stream URLs. each with different qualities for this very popular station. You're usually fine to select the top one if you don't know exactly what you're looking for, and hitting the play option next to the channel will let you listen to what they're currently playing. If the quality sounds good to you, great. If not, try another and see if one sounds the way you'd like. Selecting the title will pull up a dialog to add this station to your library. Here, you can see details about the codec, bitrate, location, and stream URL. And this can be helpful as you try to choose a stream to save. Hitting the big Add to Library button adds the new station to your library, and now it'll always be easily accessible each time you start Shortwave. Then you can simply repeat that process for each IP radio station you'd like to listen to. I love pretty much anything from Soma FM, as well as 89.3 The Current, a Twin Cities public radio station which is largely focusing on alternative and indie rock. I also love Quantum Radio, a great station featuring tracker music and fantastic demo scene vibes. What are some of your favorite streaming stations? Leave me a comment and maybe we'll all discover some new gems together. One neat thing about Shortwave is that it very conveniently records songs as it runs, and that's super helpful in totally legit ways. It appears to save the recorded file in memory, and then if you hit that little download icon, it saves an AUG of the file in your music folder. It's very useful to know what song you just listened to, so that you know what songs you'd like to legally acquire. It's also got an Add Local Station option, which is great for adding stream URLs that aren't in the public database. The dropdown next to the plus icon in the top left corner will help you get started with that. Just enter the information requested, and the station will be added to your list. Lastly, Shortwave does have support for the Google Cast feature. So if you happen to have a Chromecast and you want to use Shortwave as some sort of radio controller, you can do that pretty easily. I don't use Chromecast anymore personally, but I dug an old one out of storage and plugged it in, and it seemed to stream just fine. So what the heck is Shortwave? Well, it's a great application for managing your internet radio streams, and I'm a big fan. In the past, I'd managed these streams via Rhythmbox, or VLC, and it was always kind of painful compared with Shortwave, which is easy enough where the whole family can easily listen to and manage stations. See, Shortwave only does the one thing, and it does it really well. And that's got a ton of appeal when it comes to something as personalized as enjoying your music. Now, if there's any flaw with such a straightforward application, it's that I wish I could toggle the recording off and on for each station in the details dialog. Some stations, I'd never need the option to save recordings, but that's such a small limitation that it's barely worth mentioning. Now, if you have another streaming media application that you'd like me to check out, please let me know. I'm hoping to make more short videos like this one outlining great tools in the Linux ecosystem. GUI, Terminal, GNOME, Plasma, whatever you'd like me to try, just let me know. I'm so appreciative of Felix Häcker and anyone else contributing to make Shortwave a great application. And if you've got a few bucks to spare, I suggest supporting Felix and his work to make more fantastic Linux apps, because Linux is awesome. And so are you.
1, 2, 3, 4!
If you're still watching, make sure to say, "Don't save that AUG," in the comments.